Welcome back to the channel, guys. It's God in the Grass. Today I'm going to be talking about how you can get a prescription for medical cannabis in the UK. I've talked about it in the past just a little bit before, but you can get a prescription for medical cannabis in the UK if you have a chronic issue such as mental or physical, and you've taken two or more prescriptions for it. That could be anything that your doctor or your GP has prescribed you, and it hasn't been ideal, or it hasn't done enough, or it hasn't done anything at all. You can most definitely apply to get a medical prescription in the UK. You will most likely get one of two things, which is a cannabis oil or cannabis flower. The cannabis flower is what most people are used to if you've taken it recreationally or you've taken it medicinally, but not through the guidance of a doctor. So what you'll need is your medical records, first and foremost. I'm going to say it before I go into anything else in this video. Your medical records or your summary of care from your GP is what you're going to need first. If you're just thinking about getting a prescription for medical cannabis, or it's something that you are dead set on but you haven't yet applied, the first thing you need to do is contact your GP and ask him for a summary of care record. It will just list your medications, your past history, that sort of thing. Sometimes what they might do is just open up your patient portal, which is an online account for NHS patients, and it will show you everything. That is something that your new clinic will need in order to prove that you've had those medications, that you can be prescribed medical cannabis. And oftentimes it can be very difficult to get this from your GP. Either the wait time is too long, or you have to go through some procedure, or you have to write it to them and letter, and you have to hand it to them in person, whatever. I've had many different difficulties with my GP getting that. But if you are somebody thinking about getting a medical prescription, then realistically you should contact your GP now before you even apply. There's no harm in doing so either way. It's usually free. There's no downside. Just contact them. The second thing I'd say is research. I mean, you're already doing it now. You clicked on this video, you're looking into it. Just keep looking into it. But there are tools out there. So the one that I use the most is called Medbud.wiki. Now, that will list all the pharmacies that are available in the UK. It will list all their prices. It will list all the flour. It will list all the oil. It will tell you a lot of what I'm probably going to tell you now. So if you can, stay for the video. There are a lot of clinics in the UK already. There are some that are more popular than others. There's some that are more expensive. There's some that are more affordable. The prices usually range for the first consultation. That's when you speak to your doctor and they decide whether or not medical cannabis is right for you. That can range from anywhere between free, or I've seen it £300, some of them even more. But most of the more known ones do have offers available, but typically you'll be expecting to pay zero to maybe £100 for your first consultation. Secondly, you will have repeat prescription costs on some clinics. Some, again, don't charge for it, some do. I'm switching between clinics. There is benefit to paying a monthly prescription repeat fee, because they will have other schemes that allow you to pay less in general for the prescription itself. Some clinics even have sign-up costs, and that's not even including on the consultations. So you will have to do consultations, I believe, sometimes every 3 months or perhaps every 4 months. Those will have an additional fee. Generally speaking, from the clinics I've experienced, it's usually £50 to £100 each time. Now, the prescription itself, like I said, will either come in the form of an oil or the cannabis flower itself, the dried bud, which can either be irradiated or non-irradiated. We're not going to get into that today. Again, do your research. It's debatable what you want. It's up to you. There's reasons for it. There's reasons against it. Look into that yourself. But the prescription itself, oils, again, in my experience, have gone somewhere from about 30 to somewhere £80, but they usually meet somewhere in the middle. The flower usually ranges from about £5 a gram to sometimes, I mean, £10 plus. If you're looking for something a bit more, I don't know. It's nothing to do with the percentages. It can just to do with who's supplying the cannabis itself and how much they charge. So like I said, some clinics will offer some schemes or some projects that they're doing or something that will allow you to join their clinic. It may be that if you're switching from a clinic, they won't charge you for the initial consultation. It may be that if you're in receipt of benefits, so if you get something like universal credit or personal independence payments or veterans, there's a bunch of different ones that you can be in receipt of. But if you look at the different clinics, some of them do offer, like I said, schemes that will either cut the costs of the prescription itself, or it will cut the cost of repeat prescriptions, it will cut the cost of initial consultations altogether, or just by some, or repeat consultations, it'll cut it altogether or by some. So accessing those schemes, you're going to need some kind of proof, whether it's a letter or something that you've been given to prove that you're in receipt of those benefits. It's best to contact the clinic to see what they would prefer from you. Likewise, you'll also need proof of your address, proof of ID, along with, you know, those medical records that I previously mentioned. So lastly, the only thing I'd really recommend is that you, before jumping into the very expensive world of private prescriptions, and again, this is why I talk about it being legalized in the UK, you need to think about how you're going to be taking this medicine. Now, if you are taking it by oil and that's how you've been prescribed it, then the doctors will usually provide a syringe and it's no problem, you take it as directed. Now, if you are taking the flower, that can be a bit different in the sense that, of course, if you've been using it recreationally in the past, you might have smoked it. You might have rolled it up in some cigarette papers and smoked it just like a joint, just like most people do. Anyway, if you are getting a medical prescription, it's I would say unlikely, but more likely impossible, that your doctor is going to recommend that you smoke it. They will most likely recommend that you use a dry herb vaporizer. So there are many of these available. There is the Mighty, there's the Crafty, there's some by a company called Pax, there's one called a Dynavap, there's another that's called a Volcano, which is a bit different in the sense that you can use a lot of cannabis at once and you can put it into a balloon and then inhale it that way, but you get a lot more at once if you do it that way. But these can all be very expensive, so you're looking at somewhere between £100 to £500, depending on the vaporizer you get. You will also need a grinder, which are not as expensive, but you'd be surprised how many rubbish ones you find. So it's worth investing in all of these things. Some of the dry herb vaporizers will likely just let you pour in the flower itself, but some you can do both that, and with my one specifically, you can put them into little metal pods that I'll be showing in the future of how to use my specific vaporizer. But you put them into pods, you grind up the herb, the flower, and you put it into these pods, and it's more convenient. It's more convenient and it's more discreet, and I can take it out on the go. But most of these dry herb vaporizers are portable. Some of them are, you know, you need to have them at home and it's not something that you really want to carry around with you. But that's it. That's all there is to it. Again, it's a big investment. It's something that you need to decide whether or not it's worth it for you. I know for me that the financial difficulty that comes from paying for this medication is worth it, because my quality of life is massively improved. But I will say that forever and always, it has massively improved. I've been taking cannabis now for a year, and I can definitely say it's been the best year of my life in the past 10 or so. So that is it for today. We have discussed the basics, my advice, and everything to do with how to get a medical prescription in the UK. I advise you to keep looking at the different clinics. I can't recommend which clinics or which vaporizers or what might be best for you. It is really best to look for yourself and decide what fits for you. Okay, so I'll see you next time, guys. Remember to love yourself today and take care, and I'll see you later.